Hello everyone, and welcome to the second episode of Mario and Company Watches.
That's right, Mario. Now I bet you're wondering what we're doing in a different room instead of the one where we watched the Upside Down show in.
Well, as honor of our show where we watch DVDs and VHSs, today we're going to be watching a VHS. And we're going to do it in this room. And that is where the VCR is. The DVD player is in the other room. So, when we watch a DVD, we'll do it in that room, in the other room. And when we do a VHS, we'll watch it in this room. Simple as that.
And do any of you guys remember Alive and Cooking? Oh yes, I remember that show. Oh yes, that man on the TV made some very interesting recipes. Well, it turns out that BBC also did their own Alive and Cooking, presenting The Naked Chef.
Oh, hey, this is the one with Jamie Oliver, isn't that right?
Yeah, of course. And it was made way before our version of Alive and Cooking.
Oh, yes, I can see that.
Well, why don't we give the VHS a try?
Okie dokie, let's get snapping!
Opening is over, and I got the VHS out of its case. Let's slide it into the slot and enjoy the show. There. There we go. Oh, hang on. There.
Here's the ABC logo. ABC. I love singing at the tune. Oh, here's the confetti. BBC. I love looking at the BBC logo. Oh, here's the BBC video promo. Whoa, ho, ho. I got to turn on the volume for this one. Oh, here's the volume switch. And check it out! Whoa! It looks like I'm going into the other realm! Kicking soundtrack! Hey! 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 Oh! Teletubbies and Muddy! Oh! Wallace and Gromit! Oh! Monty Python! Or was it Wuthering Heights? Or, Whoa, what was that? Okay, that was weird. Who are you?
Alright, we can clap again.
Weird. Oh, and here he is! Jamie Oliver! Oh, yes, I know.
Cooking's gotta be a laugh. It's gotta be simple. It's gotta be tasty.
Chef's Night Off. That's a pretty good title. I think. Wow! Look at all these chefs cooking! Well, I used to be a carrot chef, but now I work in the Zootopia Police Department. Chandoy?
It's a big boy. You gonna come round tonight or what?
Yeah, sure, mate. What's happening? You cooking dinner?
Yeah, but mate, I could really do with a bit of a hand.
Right. This is a cooking show after all.
I'm gonna do roast leg of lamb. Just roast.
Ooh, what's this scrumptious meal?
I really, really like roast lamb. I mean, I like roast anything.
Oh, it's roast lamb. Yummy. No offense.
You know, I love it just with like Morgan sea salt over and roasted in the oven. That's lovely. But I kind of get bored of doing the same thing all the time. So
really?
I'm always trying to have like new ways of getting sort of flavour right stuck in there.
I see.
So first things first, what I want to do is get a knife and stick the knife down next to the Ooh. Bone at one end and just push your finger in there.
Looks like he knows what he's doing.
Rip off just half of it, so just the leaves.
Oh yeah, like rip it off, like.
And then this half, I'm going to put in the pestle and mortar.
Yeah, now sprinkle all that in, yeah.
It seems a very simple thing to do if you've got...
Who said that?
I'd expect you to do something incredibly...
Hey, there's strangers in your house, Mr. Oliver. There's strangers in your house.
Right.
Oh, wait, maybe he knows them personally.
They want to kind of be a little bit more sort of relaxed about it, you know what I mean? So I know, as long as I give them a really nice cooked piece of lamb...
They smell good.
Whatever you like with lamb, you should do. But I mean, things I've done, it's kind of, you know, get some nice, really good dry with like smashed up thyme
Man.
And butter. I mean, that works.
Well, I did have a big carrot like, feast.
You know, simple things like anchovies and
That's for the reason of the burp. Sorry.
Now, you got all that flavour in there. Now, the secret
But this is so beautiful. I can't wait to take a bite out of it when it's ready.
Of our streaky bacon. And all you need really is about 3 or 4 slices. Oh,
bacon! I love bacon.
Where'd you get it from?
You can get it from the deli, you can get it from the supermarkets, it's packs now.
Oh, I've been to supermarkets.
It's got a slight smokiness to it. You don't want loads of smokiness.
And four.
Well, I really like to cook the lamb so it's kind of pink, not bloody pink, but kind of pink.
And, isn't pink and bloody pink the same one?
And with an additional 20 minutes.
That's a pretty interesting for a Jamie Oliver.
What the trick is then is to rest it. And I'm par cooking some potatoes now. And when they're ready to go in, after about 20
Wait,
minutes.
Wait, you have some potatoes to do? That sounds delightful.
These potatoes.
Oh, I see.
For like 5 minutes.
Ooh, what yummy potatoes.
So just kind of just toss them about a bit, give them a good old shake.
Ooh.
And then what we're going to do is just get them in the oven. Where will that goodness be dripping in the old shay? Loads and loads of goodness.
Wow, look at all of that.
Just chuck them in there.
Okie dokie.
Yeah. Smell it, oh, it's going to be mad. And just put a little bit of extra rosemary in there.
That's so... It smells beautiful.
And then give them a good old shake.
Oh!
If you want to get them coated, it's going to crispen up straight away. All nice and fluffy.
Interesting!
Because they always think of them as a base for things, you know, like soups and stuff.
What are you doing with lots of onions?
Or roasted or grilled meats, this particular dish is... Superb.
Oh, you're gonna roast the onions? That's good.
A little bit of the core.
Maybe.
To make a flat edge. And then at the top, just cut down until about a centimetre and a half away from the bottom. So you don't cut it into quarters.
Wow.
Like that. But you don't go all the way down. You only go down to about there. And then just take off maybe just the skin or maybe the first layer of flesh.
Ooh, nice first layer of flesh on the onions.
I like them. You want them all the same sort of size. And they're quite easily available. And when you cook them, they get their lovely sweet.
Man, I wish I had these ingredients so I could follow along what Mr. Oliver is doing, but,
They're very big, and I can't really imagine that on someone's plate, you know?
Yes, I can see that.
That size. Cut down to. Unproof dish.
Wow.
Yeah,
well, that's a lot of salt you have on that bowl.
35 minutes at about 220 degrees, just until they kind of sag a little bit, but they'll keep their shape.
I can see that. Whoa, look at him go! Where are you going, Mr. Oliver?
Cool soundtrack. Come on, Mr. Oliver. Got no time to lose.
Hello, John. Are you alright?
Yeah. What do you fancy?
Oh, mate, I'm after some scallops. Oh, they look good. Some nice large...
Scallops.
Cool, I say. They're brilliant.
Well, seashells.
I'll give myself nine. Is that alright?
Wow. Look at all this. Looks good.
Whoa! This town looks so flying. Oh, what's this? Wow.
So for dessert, I'm going to do baked fruit.
Baked fruit?
So easy, you wouldn't believe. Wicked fruit. I'm going to make some vanilla sugar, which is...
Vanilla? You mean like Vanilla Rabbit from Sonic the Hedgehog?
I mean, all I've done, right, is I've taken the bottoms off the strawberries, I've quartered and decored the peaches, and put a bit of lemon juice on
them. Ooh, that must have taken a lot of hard work for you, Mr. Oliver.
With an olive pepper, I've sliced up the rhubarb nice and thin.
Oh, you mean like this? Like... Yeah, just like that.
Got rid of the pip, and these figs, I'm just going to sort of slice, but not quite down.
You're doing pretty good.
Like a star. And then you squeeze it like that, which I can't really explain. Real silky and it's quite heavy.
I mean,
it's
see.
Quite fattening, but you know who it is.
I mean, like.
So, and I'll just plunk that in the table. Let them help themselves.
That's pretty good. Oh, looks like someone's at your door. Oh, there he goes down the stairs. Wonder who could be behind the door. Oh, it's one of Jamie Oliver's friends. I knew he would come by one day. Well, sometime. You know what I mean. Ooh, now we got something good for the recipe. Oh, there are the scones Jamie Oliver bought.
Which basically is like a noodle soup. You can do just about anything with it.
Oh, you mean like from the Chinese?
Duck, whatever. But I'm going to kind of...
I'm an early bloomer, so what?
Don't be Bender. We deserve another chef coming
around. No offence.
The big boss coming. So I've got some nice scallops in the shell. A bit of a couple of hairs behind there. And a white
So they're talking about how they first met, eh? That's kind of like how Harry met Sally. Pretty interesting.
Get a nice big sheet.
Wow, that's a pretty nice silver sheet.
Tin foil. Just a bit of oil, mate. Salt and pepper.
Oh, yeah, the salt and pepper.
So just imagine this is like a letter or a Christmas present or something like that.
Yeah.
Just put a bit of oil in the bottom.
Oh, okay, so I just roll it like that.
Clams are probably going to need the most amount of heat, yeah?
Just like that. Yeah, okay, got it.
And then the second thing what we need more cooking is...
Well, that brings our episode to a close. But The Naked Chef is a pretty good cooking show.
It sure was. It definitely was.
Yep, of course it was. Well, everyone, tune in next time for another episode of Mario and Company Watches.
Now, if you'll excuse us, we're going to be doing some cooking business ourselves.
Oh, man, I really love Alive and the Cooking.
Me too. Me free.
Me far.